Why do feet sweat in the winter? We all know that our bodies primarily sweat to cool us down, so in the winter, we're usually sweating less. Except that my feet have never been as sweaty as they are in my winter boots. It makes sense why feet that get sweaty stay sweaty in boots because, you know, good winter boots are waterproof, so they keep the sweat in. But why do those feet get sweaty in the cold winter in the first place when the rest of my body is perfectly dry? It turns out we don't just sweat to cool ourselves down. Emotions can also make us sweat. Now, that thermoregulatory sweating is the only type of sweating that's medically necessary. In fact, it turns out that the scientific definition of hyperhidrosis or excessive sweating is simply any sweating in excess of what's required for thermoregulation. Under that broad definition, though, almost all of us have hyperhidrosis because almost all of us sweat emotionally. Millions of years ago, when our ancestors, when mammals were first taking over the world, they evolved the ability to sweat on their paws. Now, this allowed them to run with perfect grip across a variety of surfaces, and this is something that persists today in many modern mammals. For example, there was a study where they took dogs and they blocked the ability of their paws to sweat, and then they put these dogs on treadmills and the dogs just started sliding around. This is even true for humans. When your hands are completely dry, your grip isn't as good as when they're a tiny bit sweaty, a tiny bit damp, but once it gets to a certain point, that grip starts diminishing because in the case of humans, our hands and feet get way too sweaty. Humans uniquely evolved the ability beyond almost all mammals to sweat all over our body to cool ourselves down. And this has led to an overregulation of the emotional sweating. So our hands, our feet, our underarms, the primary areas of emotional sweating, they sweat way beyond what's necessary for this ideal grip. They sweat to the point where it gets slippery and annoying, and then we get sweaty feet in the winter. Unless you spend your entire day in an emotionless Zen trance, you're probably gonna have at least a few moments of sweaty feet. And unlike summer shoes, winter boots won't let those feet dry out until you take them off. So, what can you do about those sweaty winter feet? Well, the simplest solution, and my favorite, obviously, as the co-founder of Carpe, is Carpe Foot Antiperspirant. It's like an underarm antiperspirant, but designed specifically to stop sweaty feet. It's got over 5,000 five-star reviews on Amazon, and basically you just put it on before bed, again in the morning, and it's gonna help your feet sweat less all day long, all winter long. Besides Carpe, you basically have two ways to go about this. You can create ways for your feet to dry more easily, or you can prevent them from sweating at all with more intensive medical treatments. To give your feet more opportunities to dry, you basically wanna keep them out of those heavy, occluded winter boots as much as possible. So around the house, wear sweat-wicking socks, and another thing that works very well for me is fleece-lined slippers. I wear these fleece-lined Crocs. If you have extreme foot sweat, you may want to seek out more intensive medical treatments. A common one is called iontophoresis. This requires a doctor's prescription and basically involves running electric current through your feet, through these little foot baths. Scientists aren't sure why this works, but it certainly does seem to stop the sweat for a lot of people. Beyond iontophoresis, a dermatologist may recommend Botox injections at the site of the sweating, and that's basically where they stop the sweat, or anticholinergic pills, which reduce sweating all over the body. Now, these are a bit more dangerous because they can interfere with thermoregulatory sweating, but that's why they require a doctor's prescription. So if Carpe and good breathable socks aren't quite doing it for you, talking with a dermatologist is definitely a good option to explore what the more intensive treatments could be. And there you have it. Sweaty feet in the winter are an annoying evolutionary misstep, but there's plenty of good ways to manage them. I hope that some of these tips help your feet stay as dry as mine. Till next time, stay dry.